Putting that block down there on position two already. Matt Colbert, I'm sure, is just slamming that thing as well on the opposite side. Harden Coker Jr., Zach Cross, whittled away on the far side. It looks like they're going like perpendicular to each other every time they go around. I like this. The lefties and the righties working together here. Looks like Jason's already veeing himself off in the middle of that block there.
Zach, breathe.
On his heel face. Now he's going to have to go for that far wood. And you see as he steps around, he's more easily able to access that far wood. 28 inches. Your axe cannot actually reach all the way across this. You're going to have to step around the thing to be able to cut the full scar. Addressing his fans in the middle of the cut. Now him and Trevor will talk about it. Engineers up there at UNH College. I mean, Trevor took 10 years to get a master's, so I mean, yeah, Ben's trying to learn something there on position three. Hennigan and Engasser got a great cut going right now. Looks like Engasser's really taking the far wood out of there, meeting that far line already.
Yeah, go ahead.
Looks like Matt is going for the drives over there on position two with Jason. Jason's trying to break that forward for Matt. Driving concurrently right now. Just don't want those blades to meet. Middle of the axe. Ooh, big chip there. Down on position five for Adam. Ben Marshall's tagging Tyler, and it looks like they're going to tag the excavator operator. And oh, my Lord. Here we go. He's cheating. All right. They're cheating now on position number three. All right.
Make board holes.
Insert white.
Make board holes now.
Board holes?
Board holes. All through the rest of it.
They're like, we'll take the DQ. Balling like a baseball game. Tyler White now. Oh, strike one there for White out of Unadilla, New York. He's already red there in the face. Oh boy, that's not a sunburn, folks. He's in trouble. There it is! Matt Coger, Jason Lentz.
He's on board.
Take the heat. Shooter Coker jumped in down there for Jamie at position one.
Keep on, boys.
They're Cobras. It's a relation. That counts. That's legal, all right? That's legal.
Keep on going. Born in the
script. Make more holes. Right now, it looks like right across.
Pick it up on the bottom.
Heading trying to get into the center of that box. Looks like there's still quite a bit of wood there in the center. Trying to get it to break up. I kind of want to navigate this from the mind of Tyler White for a second if we can.
There's a lot of
bees.
There's a big chip. Take that. Step around. Timer done.
Here, Zach, let me
spray. All right, Bogry's now bludgeoning away at this thing. The wizard switching sides. He's like, wow, this is what it feels like to cut on a real scarf. Wow. You got it, boys. Keep it going. Cheer them on, folks. This is a lot of work. A lot of work. God, I'm telling you, the communication on stand three is just amazing. I wish there was a mic up ceremony over there. Alright, Jamie's back in. Browse has stepped out. Insert Jason McCadden. Where'd he come from? Stand Number five, stepping in for the big axe man, Ryan Bourne. I think Ryan realizing this one. Man, 28, what you want? Not a place for an 8-inch axe. Nope.
I really hate you guys.
This is pandemonium.
Zach, work this far forward. We can talk. It's wiggling.
Matt Coker and Jason Munch, you guys are definitely making this look a lot easier than it is. Billy's out. He's like, yeah, okay. I've had enough of this side. That's my cardio for the week. All right, the block is wobbling there. On position number four. Give it up for Edgasser and Henning.
Go. All right, single buck final here. Big hang by Manny swinging on five. Now he's going to have to try to find the pace to catch up to Billy Cornelius, who's got a great shot, great cut going down there. And Jason Lance on position number three.
So today, with the Cherry Valley Outdoor Games, we are sitting under a tent in the rain. Yay.
3, 2, 1, go! All right, here we go. First heat, one single back here today. Great cut going by Jewett there. Look at JP though, hogging the road out. On position number four, Jamie into the bottom now. On position number one.
It's Cherry Valley recap. It was an interesting weekend. I was very pleased with how I hot sawed and I single bucked well. And I actually thought I cut my underhands pretty darn good. I just didn't draw the best of wood. That's part of the sport that a lot of people don't understand. In America, we have events that, you know, the organizers do their best to get as even a wood as you possibly can. However, there are some blocks that are going to cut marginally, if not quite a bit faster than others, and some of us drew those logs. And I'm not going to complain about it because I've been doing this stuff long enough to know that that's part of the sport. Even though I, you know, drew a tough log in the standing, I think that I should have cut it better. You know, I think I could have cut that log fast enough to make the top 10, where I would have made had the potential to make the top six and gotten a, you know, a chance at a better cut. But so be it. That's part of it. But the one thing that I learned from this weekend is that I have got to start putting weight on my back foot in that tree. I have got to freaking just let it go. I had the perfect 4 and 6 hit climb, got up there, and then hit the log like a complete bitch. I got to do better than that. I mean, the wood was firm. I couldn't draw. The axe went in like nothing. I mean, like, I was hitting it all with what I had in me. And then when I realized it was that firm, I was like, oh, crap. And I just didn't step back further on the board and hit it like a man, you know. So, live and learn, move on, and make the most of it. So, it was fun. Much thanks to Nathan and Holly Waterfield and the entire community of Cherry Valley for putting on a wonderful event. That takes a lot of work. It's a thankless job, and they really want to make that event something big and successful. And even though the weather didn't cooperate the second day, it was a wonderful crowd on Friday and a wonderful crowd on Saturday. And so my hat goes off to them for hosting a lovely event. Can't do much better than that. So that's onward and upward.